Hello everyone, my name is Iris France, 我叫林婉如. Today we're going to continue to talk about exchange. In particular, we're going to talk about Pareto efficient allocations. So the definition of efficiency is this. You will not be able to improve Alice's utility without hurting Bob's utility. Then we know the outcome is efficient. And vice versa. So, say, we cannot improve Bob's utility without hurting Alice's utility. Then you know the allocation of good one and good two is efficient. So, that means if you can improve one person's utility without hurting the other person's utility, then you know the outcome is still inefficient. So, for example, our endowment W, notice that you can move from W to Y. In that case, if you're moving from W to Y, you can see Alice's utility has been improved. We're moving to a higher indifference curve. And Bob's is on the same utility curve, so Bob's utility is not hurt. And therefore, you know point W is inefficient. So once you move to point Y, the second point I want you to remember is this. For efficient allocations, the indifference curve of two people must be tangent to each other. If the indifference curves are not tangent to each other, then you know the allocation of good one and good two is inefficient. So why is that? Notice that when we are intersecting with each other, the indifference curves are intersecting with each other, then we can always improve, move a little bit to this direction, and for both Alice and Bob, our utility can be improved. But once you're tangent to each other, you know that you can no longer improve. So, for example, suppose we're on this point, then for Alice to improve her utility, we must make sure that Bob's utility is going down. Then we know this point is efficient. Or if we're point Y, then for Bob to improve his utility, we must be moving to this direction, and then we'll be hurting Alice's utility. So we know point Y is already efficient. In fact, you find all the tangent of the indifference curves, and then you connect them, you will get the contract curve. The contract curve tells you how the final contract will look like. So suppose there is initial endowment, eventually we will be moving toward the contract curve for the outcome to be efficient. Finally, efficiency doesn't mean that it's desirable. So for example, if we're at this point where Alice has nothing and Bob has everything, well, is this point efficient? Absolutely, yes, it's efficient when Alice has nothing. Why? Because in order for Alice to improve her utility, we must be hurting Bob's utility because Bob will have to give up a little bit of good one or a little bit of good two or both for Alice to gain some utility. And therefore, we're hurting Bob's utility, so you know, at this point, where Alice has nothing and Bob has everything, the outcome is efficient. But is it desirable? Of course not. We don't want a society where you have someone has nothing and the other person has everything, because we know that's where a revolution comes from. Well, for the French Revolution, because the people in the bottom, they had nothing to eat, so they start a revolt. So efficiency doesn't mean that it's desirable. So I hope this helps, and in the next videos, I'm going to talk about Moore's Law. So I hope this helps. See you next time.